Good morning. Yeah, welcome to another edition of Import Export Platform Facebook Live from 3 Timpers Art Academy. We continue our conversation this morning on starting and managing export business, and today we are looking at part 70. We have just about 3 episodes to go to 100. And I'm hoping we are going to hit 100 at this rate, because there's so much more to discuss, as far as export business is concerned. I'm hoping this will be an epic program for anyone intending to start export business, for them to know exactly what to do to be able to get into the business. Yesterday, we talked about unit price and Incoterms. I'm hoping that we'll finish this morning as I start discussing contract period, inspection agent, and country of origin. Remember what we are talking about? We are actually discussing full corporate offer. And a full corporate offer is the information you are sending to the your prospective buyer for the very first time. And I've said severally that first impression matters a lot, and that the impression you are creating with this first message you are sending goes a long way to show if eventually you are going to get a contract in the first place. I've also emphasized the fact that getting buyer's contact is not enough for you to think you have a contract, because you need to now demonstrate to that buyer that you are credible and they can afford to give you the contract. They can afford to give you the contract. By that, I mean the sales contract. So, and I've emphasized the fact that don't be excited because you have a contract. Don't be excited because you have a contract. Contact, rather. Be excited when you get the contract. Contact detail does not translate automatically to sales contract. Contact detail does not translate automatically to sales contract. You need to work on getting a sales contract after getting the contact. And one of the things you need to do is to send a mail to the buyer you are dealing with. And in sending that mail, I've made a couple of recommendations. And that's what we're going to be discussing this morning. So, the next thing on our list, let me just go through the full corporate offer again. Seller's name, seller's address. Product description and product quality specification. Minimum and maximum order. Payment terms and payment method. Duration for shipment. Unit price and Incoterms. The next thing we are going to be looking at is contract period. Remember, this contract will not last forever. This contract will have to terminate at some point. When will the contract terminate? What are the conditions that will make the contract terminate? Is there any room for automatic extension of the contract? Is there any room for automatic renewal of the contract? If it's to be terminated before the expiry, how will that happen? Contract period. For how long will this contract last? You know what? This contract is supposed to last for a particular period. For example, this contract is supposed to last for 3 months. If I say the contract will last for 3 months, that means within 2 months or 1 month, I should have been able to deliver. It's expected that I will deliver earlier than the proposed longevity or timeline of that contract. It is assumed that if I say this contract should last for so-so period, then it's assumed that I will finish early. So that means when I say the contract period is 3 months, the buyer is thinking that, okay, most likely we ship in 2 months. So if my duration for shipment is 2 months, if my duration for shipment is 2 months, I cannot say contract period will be, if my duration of shipment is 3 months, I cannot say contract period will be 2 months. It should be consistent such that at the end of the day, the contract period I am choosing accommodate the shipment period. Typically, people will say contract period is for 1 year. But within that 1 year, it is expected that shipment will have taken place. So, why is contract period necessary? The buyer will like to know, are you looking at for a long-term relationship or you are looking for a short-term relationship? What is your objective in this marriage, in this relationship? If it's a buyer that is looking for a long-term relationship and you are asking for a short-term relationship, that might define their interest. When you are trying to do a trade transaction, always be long-term focus. Why? Most people you are dealing with most likely have been in the business for a while. What a buyer does not want is to having to look for a supplier every time he needs the product. So typically, a buyer is looking for a more secure business relationship. So if that is not your own ideal, is that not what you are looking at? That might be a challenge for the buyer. So try as much as possible to be long-term focused in your thinking. And this is the reason why you must do what you are asked to do. You cannot afford to disappoint, because it's good for you also as an exporter. Why would you be an exporter and every time you ship, you have to be looking for a new person to do business with? Why? Does it make sense? Why is it that every time you ship, you'll be looking for someone, a new person to do business with? Why is it that you can't perform so well that the buyer will say, guy, we have found a good relationship with you. We are not looking for someone else again. Can we solidify this arrangement? Can we solidify this business relationship? That should be what you should be looking at as a business person. You don't want to be a business person that every time you have to get someone new. So in your arrangement with the buyer, you should clearly state how long the contract should last. The next thing I'll be talking about is inspection. Remember this, international trade. In international trade, a buyer sometimes most likely might have to pay before he sees the goods. If that is the case, then you need to ask yourself, what do I need to do to give this buyer comfort so that he will not have to wait for goods to arrive before he pays me? He pays me immediately, I do the shipment, and I send him document that evidence that I've done the shipment. Sending him document that evidence that I've done the shipment should make him to pay. If he's not willing to pay, then something is wrong. Something is wrong before us, that means he's not sure of the quality of what he will get. If he has seen the quality of what he will get, if he's not sure of what he's paying for, most likely he will not have issue paying. But if he's not sure, He will want to wait for the goods to arrive. And you know what? He will want to see the goods before he effect payment. But you know what I discovered? For you as an exporter, that's not a good one at all. For you as an exporter, that's not a good one at all. That's not a good one at all because for you as an exporter, what that does for you is that it makes life difficult for you. It makes life difficult for you. Why? It shook you up. It shook off your finances. It makes it difficult for you to be able to do more transactions. Why? Because your money is lying in the hand of your partner. Your money is lying in the hand of your partner. Your money is lying in the hand of your partner. If your money remains in the hand of your business partner, how then do you do the business? If your money remains in the hand of your business partner, how then do you do the business? So you want to have a neat arrangement. You want to have a neat arrangement. You want to have an arrangement that ensures that at the end of the day, you are secured. You want to have an arrangement that ensures that at the end of the day, you are secured. You need to understand how important this is. You don't want a situation in which most part of your money is in the hand of your buyer. In fact, it's been suggested that no more than 40% of your credit given to the buyer. No more than 40%. Why? Because if you allow your buyer to hold a good chunk of your capital, in a short time, you will be out of business. But let me now tell you the major risk that you face when you do that. If that business have any problem, you will be in trouble. You will be in trouble. If that business have any problem. Why? Let me give you an example. During the financial crisis that happened in 2008-2009, a lot of business failed, not because they don't have money, but because majority of their money were in the hand of their buyer. If you are going to give out credit, it's okay. But don't give out credit that strangulates your own business. If you are going to give out credit, it's okay. But don't give out a credit that strangulates your own business. Giving out credit is not bad in itself, but giving out credit should be done with wisdom. Giving out credit should be done with wisdom. It should be done in such a way that you will remain alive. It should be done in such a way that you will remain alive. You don't want to give credit to your customer and then you are dead by the time he pays or when he's ready to pay. Your business has to be alive also. Your business has to be alive also. If your business is not alive, then it becomes difficult for you to even continue. So you want to ensure you give credit, but no more than 40% of your capital. Now, a buyer will only pay you ahead, because the only way you avoid that credit is when a buyer pays you ahead of when payment is due. That means he pays you ahead before he gets the goods. A buyer will only do that when the buyer is sure of what he's getting. A buyer will only do that when the buyer is sure what he's getting. The question is this: what effort are you making to ensure that the buyer is comfortable with you as a business person? What effort are you making to ensure that the buyer is comfortable with you as a business person? What effort are you making? That is why on your full corporate offer, you are putting there Inspection Agent, SGS. Inspection Agent, SGS. Inspection Agent, SGS. Inspection Agent, SGS. Or Inspection Agent, Be Real Veritas. Inspection Agent, Be Real Veritas. Inspection Agent, Cotecna. Inspection Agent, Cotecna. Inspection Agent, Intertech. inspection agent Intertek. These are international inspection agents that most likely the buyer knows and is familiar with. So when I put inspection on my contract, on my full corporate offer, I'm basically telling the buyer that, you know what? I have people in my country that can check the quality of this product before they are shipped. Please, go ahead and give me the contract. I have people in my country that is going to, that will be able to check the quality. So go ahead and give me the contract and please pay before you see the goods. If you want to prevent giving credit, if you want to ensure you get payment as at when due, then work towards ensuring. Work towards ensuring that for your export transaction, you have given the buyer an idea of the fact that you have an inspection agent that he can work with. That you have an inspection agent that he can work with. And this inspection agent gives him comfort to want to do business with you. This inspection agent gives me comfort to want to pay ahead of when good arrive. Why will a buyer not want to pay before good arrive? The buyer is afraid that you will not deliver on your promises. Why will a buyer not pay until good arrive? The buyer is not sure that you will be able to deliver the right quality and the right quantity. Why will a buyer not pay before the good arrive? The buyer is trying to tread carefully so as to ensure that at the end of the day, he will not be paying for goods of bad quality of low grade. I'm basically telling you that a buyer don't mind paying, but they will only pay when you have given them comfort of what effort you have put in place to secure their money. How do you put that effort in place? By ensuring that there is a quality and quantity inspection of that good before shipment. By ensuring that there is a quality and quantity inspection of that good before shipment. And this is so important because being able to do that makes life easy for everyone. Being able to do that makes life easy for you, makes life easy for the buyer, makes life easy for everyone who is involved in that transaction. A buyer don't mind paying you. In fact, I dare say that most buyers do not have issue paying you. They have issue paying for low-grade quality, bad quality, no shipment. They have issue paying for low-grade quality, bad quality, and no shipment. No shipment, as in no shipment at all. No shipment at all. And they are trying to safeguard themselves against the risk of non-shipment, against the risk of low-grade shipment, against the risk of bad quality shipment, against the risk of no shipment, as in no shipment. Can you imagine that? That there will be no shipment. No shipment. As in, no shipment. Zero shipment. But there is a document being presented for payment. That is international trade for you. No shipment, but someone is presenting document for payment. No shipment, but someone is presenting document for payment. No shipment, but someone is presenting document for payment. How then should you ensure that the buyer is comfortable to tell you to go ahead and do what you want to do in terms of getting paid ahead of when good arrive? You can only cover that by ensuring that there is quality inspection before shipment. Like I said, I've given you an example, Bere Veritas, SGS, Cotecna, and Intertek. Bere Veritas, SGS, Cotecna, and Intertek. These are the agency or bodies that you can contact to help you with do the inspection. And some of them are in Nigeria, actually. Some of them are in Nigeria. Lastly, but not the least, country of origin. Lastly, but not the least, country of origin. Now, some buyer already have an idea of quality of different product from different country, especially agro commodity. When you indicate where the good is coming from, you give them an insight into the kind of quality of product they should expect. However, this quality of product that they should expect will only be valid for them when they have an idea of the country, sometimes the place within that country. Let me give an example. If someone is buying cashew nut from Nigeria and you put their country of origin, Nigeria, and you put Ogbomosho product, Ogbomosho commodity. If that importer is aware and familiar with Nigeria, which a number of them are familiar with, he will prefer what you've said. You have not just said this cashew nut is from Nigeria in general, but Ogbomosho town in particular, because Ogbomosho town has the best quality of raw cashew nut in Nigeria. They have jumbo nut of bigger sizes, low nut count, high kernel output ratio. Low nut count, high kernel output ratio. So they will be able to appreciate what you're saying. Another issue with origin is this. When you talk in terms of origin, always remember that some countries have what is called preferential treatment, preferential agreement, preferential trade agreement or treatment. And what this has done is this. It has made some country to give concession to some countries. I had an experience some time ago. We were to ship sesame seed to China. The buyer gave us an offer of a price, and I had issue with that price, so I was following up on them, telling them to cut down the price. And they said, no, they won't. And we were back and forth. I wanted them to increase the price, They wanted to cut down the price. And they told me, we will give you this price if you can give us a certificate of origin showing that this good originated from Niger. And I said, number one is unethical. That means I have to be getting certificate that is not from Nigeria, saying it's from Nigeria, even though the good is from Nigeria. Number two, it really does not make sense. But do you know why he was saying that? The Chinese government give rebate to Niger shipment, because a lot of Niger exporting do not pay duties as much as Nigerians to China. So when they are charging them 5% duty, they might be charging Nigerian product 20% duty. That's a preferential treatment for Niger Republic, because as far as Chinese are concerned, Niger is poorer than Nigeria. Nigeria has a lot of money, they just have bad managers. So Nigeria should go and get good manager, but they are going to pay more. It's encouraging trade with Niger, and discouraging trade of that particular product with Nigeria. What am I trying to say in essence? Country of origin also influence what the price will be, and that was the exact situation with the Chinese guy who were trying to sell 7C2 that was telling us to attach a certificate of origin that this good originated from Niger, and that if you can get that, then you'll be able to give us the price we are looking for. And we told him we will not be able to deal on that because for us, that is very, very unethical. All right, I've come to the end of today. Discussion today on starting and managing export business, part 70, and we have discussed full corporate offer, contract period, inspection agent, and country of origin. Contract period, inspection agent, and country of origin. Thank you very much for listening. My name is Dela Imba. This is Import Export Platform Facebook Live from Treat Ready Academy. Remember this video, go to our YouTube channel. And to be able to get more videos, visit our YouTube channel. That's youtube.com/latinityimpacts. When you visit the channel, please remember to subscribe to our channel. Click on the bell to give you notification when you upload a new video. But more importantly, share the video with your friends and family. Drop your comment and like the video. Thank you very much for listening. Bye for now and see you in the evening as we continue our conversation on starting and managing export business. But this time around, I'll be looking at part 71. And I will be discussing export market entry strategies. Export market entry strategies. Bye for now and have a good day at work.